A fine hearty hi, fishers, and welcome to our Fishtails Fishing Tournament. Now, I want you to do two things. Sign up for your favorite contest and have a great time fishing. Hey there, Taylor.
Hey, Joe. This is Drew.
Hello.
Good to meet you, Drew. And these are my friends, Gabby, Maya, Amanda, and Alec.
Howdy, hi.
Hello.
Hello.
And our reigning tournament champ, Tia.
Thank you. Well, Tia's not off the hook today, because she's in for some competition from Miss Gillian, from Miss Gabriella Gill.
Oh, really, Miss Gill?
At this competition, you guys fish while we tell stories.
Not just any stories, Bible stories about fish.
But what do we like to call them?
Fish tales!
Why you go first?
fishing your shirt, cap, even on your tackle box, Jill.
You mean these two curved lines that cross to form a fish?
Uh-huh.
That's called ichthus. In Greek, it stands for Jesus Christ, God's Son, Savior.
Oh yeah, I see those igloos everywhere.
No, not igloos, ichthus. Nowadays, most everyone knows the fish is a symbol for the Christian faith. But hundreds of years ago, the fish was a secret sign, not only to believers.
Jesus made us delicious dish of
articles, it seemed too good to be true.
Yeah.
But it is true, you see. God's the master of miracle math. Why just read what it says from my pocket New Testament? See? Matthew 14:20, where I drew the little fish.
They all ate and were satisfied. The disciples picked up 12 basketfuls of broken pieces that were left over.
Sweet. Sounds like the all-you-can-eat night fisherman friends.
Yeah, that makes the pilgrim's feast seem like a picnic.
And according to this passage, it was a day of Thanksgiving for Jesus too. Because what does scripture say?
Taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish and looking up to heaven, he gave thanks and broke the loaves. Then he gave them to the disciples and the disciples gave them to the people.
But who was Jesus thanking?
His Heavenly Father. Our Heavenly Father. Because whether it's a fish sandwich or a pilgrim's feast, it's always God who provides it and God who deserves our thanks. So Jesus was like saying a blessing over the food? Something like that.
At my house, we just say, God is great, God is good, and we thank him for our food.
Well, Amanda, if those words come from a truly thankful heart, then that's a mighty fine prayer.
It looks like a life
You bring him in.
Me? Thanks, Tia.
He's putting up a fight, so reel him in slowly now.
Jesus died to rise again, because he gave his life upon the cross and paid the price of sin for us. That
you.
Now I finally understand what's good about Good Friday.
Good for you, Drew. You see, if Jesus hadn't died, we wouldn't have the wonderful news that we call the gospel. That Jesus Christ gave his life on the cross to forgive our sins and offer everyone who believes in him eternal life.
That's the story of Easter.
That's the glory of Easter.
You're right. So my fish tale is entitled, Good Fish for Easter Day.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Fish for Easter? Tia, as much as you love fishing, I think you have fish every day.
Nope. On Easter, my mom always buys a veggie dinner roast.
Ooh.
Well, just listen, and I think you'll see why my story is called Good Fish for Easter Day. Watch your lines, guys. I've seen a lot of fish jumping out there today.
Really? Amanda, have I lost my bait?
No, you wax swim still, that's waxy.
All right, so here's the rest of the story. Now, after Jesus was crucified and then died, some of his friends removed his body from the cross and wrapped him in clean linens, sometimes called grave clothes. Then, they closed the entrance with a large boulder, much like that big rock over there on the shore. Then, to make sure no one could steal Jesus' body, Roman guards sealed the tomb and stood around the clock on either side of the grave.
Thank you.
No, because the fishtail isn't finished.
There's no way you can improve an ending like that, Jill.
Well, hurry up and get to the fish in the story.
Remember, Tia, patience is a mark of a good fisherman.
Died, the disciples were confused and scared. And when they heard that he's risen from the dead, it just seemed
too good to be true.
You're right, Taylor. So later on, Jesus appeared to two disciples as they were
fishing.
No, they were on their way to a town called Emmaus
to buy fish.
No, but you're getting close, because on that very same night, Jesus appeared to the disciples once more as they were eating
fish.
Yes.
Good answer.
No autographs, please. Seriously, Tia, this appearance was really cool.
Just imagine the scene. The room was probably dark with oil lamps casting mysterious shadows. But right before their eyes, Jesus appeared in the room. And like, he didn't come through a door or window, but he walked right through the wall.
No way. Was he a ghost?
A ghost? Now that's a silly question.
Well, that's what most people would have asked. So how about I answer that question? Do chickens have lips? Do pigs have wings? Now who would ask? Such silly things. Do ghosts have bones? Do spirits have flesh? Jesus answered those two questions when he rose from death.
He was flesh and bones with hands and feet, and through it true, he asked to eat. But the Lord ate fish, it was the lump. He was alive, the risen Christ, the flesh and bones.
doesn't.
Thank you.
Boy, I could get hooked on that music. But Tia, why are you giving me the fish eye?
Well, the disciples have to give up fishing for fish, I mean.
Oh no, Tia. In fact, that's the other part of this fish tale.
You mean the part where Jesus told the disciples to cast their nets?
Like these little dip nets?
No, Taylor. Big, heavy nets that the fish would swim right into.
That sounds easy.
Oh no, many times the disciples would stay up all night and never catch a thing. But when they put their trust in Jesus and cast their nets where he told them to, they caught a boatload of fish.
Sounds like me at the weigh-in. Oh, Tia, just listen to how Luke and John tell the story.
In English and Espanol, por favor.
Why are you leaving, Tia?
I guess you could say I'm going where the big ones are.
And where's that, Tia?
My home, my school, even my own neighborhood.
What are you gonna catch there?
My big brother, I hope. Then maybe the girl down the street who calls me a fishing geek.
Tia, you'll be as good a fisher man as you are a fisher woman.
You're right, Gabby. So let's name Tia the winner of this tournament's weigh-in. I am a fish.
But the people that you're gonna bring to Jesus are worth more than a whole boatload of fish.
All right. Well, you're not off the hook, Gabby, because this fisher girl will be back again. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
So, Jill, does this mean the tournament is over?
Well, that's up to you guys.
Do you think you caught your limit?
No. Not a fish, I mean. But I think we sure did catch the message in your fish tales.
Yeah, that just like Jesus, we should be thankful for all God does.
And that Jesus waits patiently for us to come to him.
And that if we follow Jesus, he'll make us fishers of men.
An excellent decision.